Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Today we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna customize some floor mats for the FFRS build. So what the plan is, we're gonna go from this to this on today's episode. Stay tuned. So here's where we're starting. I ordered floor mats. I looked for sets of custom floor mats, stuff like that. I just didn't find what I liked. So what I did was I ran into these. They are metal RS badges for grill placement. So they're threaded on the back like that. So they actually come with hardware two long double threaded screws with some nuts, and then some little backer plates. So I was like, I feel like I can make these work. So I got a handful of them. Now the idea here is I bought a set of all weather floor mats, and there's the third row is chilling over here. But I also bought a brand new set of OEM carpeted floor mats. So the plan here is to customize both sets, and these will be my show mats, and then these will be my everyday mats, because again, this is a family car, this is my daily car, my kids are in and out of this car multiple times a day, and that's not going to change with the car being built. So we're going to go ahead and do the all weathers first, and the all weather floor mats I went with are these 3D Max Pydar, if I'm pronouncing that right. But they're really good. I looked at a ton of different options and these seem to be the nicest. They're really kind of got a cool rubbery feel to them. Very durable. And then the back is actually like a rough male Velcro. So it's really gonna stick. From the reviews I've read, they really stick in the carpet really well. I haven't tried them in the car because my car is gutted and there's no carpet. So. We're just going under the fact that they look really great. The coverage on them, they go really high on the sides, which I'm really all about. And then the second row is super nice and high as well. So I kind of prepped this a little bit. So we'll go ahead and show you what we need. These are plastic and they had two little caps on the back that were plastic. So I just went ahead and popped them off. Okay, so that's all those are. We got two existing holes. These are not set yet. I placed that there so you guys can see what we're looking like. But what I did was I went ahead and made a template for the holes of the threaded portion. So those are going to match up exactly what we want. So I got those set. Then I also got a silver Sharpie. So that's where we're going to mark our holes with. So I can clearly see them against the black. I got a couple drill bits. We're going to start with this one. And that is a 3/16. We might have to go up to this guy. I think we're gonna be okay with here though. I originally did get these screws to do this project from Home Depot. Where did I get those from? Lowe's. So I got them from Lowe's. And the half inch was too long. There was two bagging in the back, so I had to go to our local hardware store, which is called Hardware Sales here in Bellingham. And they literally have everything. So we got quarter inch. They are tiny. And then I got additional washers. So I'm going to go ahead and show you what we're going to do. Let me go ahead. So because the two front floor mats have existing holes, we have to use one of these and then we'll plot out where the other hole is going to be. But just so we're not putting multiple crazy holes into the floor mats, I don't want these to leak. So we're going to keep the locations here. This is one of my grill badges, and I got it just to kind of plot it out. So this is kind of what it's going to look like. Personally, I like it on the side a lot better. I think, so when you open the door, you're seeing that RS. So that's the style we're gonna do with the show mats. We're gonna go sideways because there's no holes in those, and we can kind of pick and choose where we want. But I'm gonna go ahead and match these up with the current holes. Just so we don't, like I said, we're not putting multiple holes in the floor mats. So that's the plan. I'll set this guy on the time lapse. You guys can kind of watch the process. So this is what I decided to do as far as getting the second row mat, because it's all one mat, as you can see. Here's our passenger mat. They really look good. So I'm literally just putting two rulers, making sure they're straight. This kind of bows out a little bit, so the rulers are straight. And then I'm just putting my template right in the corner. So I'm going to mark the holes. I'm going to do the same on this side. And then I'm going to go ahead and drill the holes, and then we'll get the second row done. So that's the plan. Just so you guys know. All right, y'all, so I have the all weathers all completely done. I'm getting ready. I got everything laid out over here on the passenger mount for the show mats, the carpeted mats. So here's the sucky part. I don't currently have the car here because it's getting the exhaust done. So I can't remember which side the curve goes on, because only one corner is curved on the second row floor mats. So I'm probably gonna have to wait on the second row until I get the car back. But we'll go ahead and do the driver's and the passenger side, get those knocked out, and then I'm trying to decide if I wanna put one in the third row. We very seldomly have people in the third row, and this is the third row, so I'm honestly not even quite sure where I'd put one, because this is the spot that people will like step constantly here. And then I suppose your feet would kind of be like here-ish. So I'm kind of debating on just putting a single right here in the center. But I'm not sure yet. So maybe I'll ask my little guy, Caleb, over there on the counter, on the couch, what he thinks about it. I'll go ahead and knock these out, and then maybe we'll try to get some kind of decision on the third row. If not, I can always wait, because I'm going to have to bust everything back out to do the second row. But all right. let's do these carpeted mats, and then we'll see where we're at. So, we got the holes marked up with the pink. Now we're gonna go ahead and try to drill them. Now, I think what I'm gonna do is I think I'm gonna put them on a box and try to drill down through into a box. My huge intercooler box is like right here, so I think we'll just go ahead and use that. So, and hopefully it works. Here we go. Let's see. Besides the intercooler, huh? I'm gonna make sure I'm not gonna drill into my intercooler. Okay. That's it. We're good. Alright, here we go. So, seems to have worked good. Let's go ahead and see if we can plug in the batch here. See how it's gonna line up. Holes are there. Feel it. Same deal. I'm gonna go ahead and push it through and around with the flathead. So I'm gonna thread one in first because it kind of doesn't want to stay there. So take the difficult side, get it lined up. Let's get it threaded. All right, like so. Let me shove that one too. That. Oh, wow. Wow, you guys, that looks so good. Look how like flush into the carpet it is. Wow, they look great. Yeah, that side just barely sticks out, but that'll mat down a little bit, but wow. Like as far as a mat, that definitely looks OEM quality. I think it's gonna look so sweet sitting in the car. So yeah, so that's how that turned out. Let's go ahead and I'll drill the driver's side. And we'll be the good one too.
Wow, you guys, they look so good. So let's get a nice little shot of these. Wow. Check it out. I am so impressed with these. I'm so stoked that the vision came out to what I wanted it to be. I mean, they're really, they're very flush. Like, they're not sticking out at all. Held in place really solid. They're definitely not going anywhere. So from blank, plain to full custom OEM style factory Ford Flex RS floor mats. Not to mention our all weathers, which came out super good also, because that's what'll be rocking on the daily. Keeping the carpet nice and clean, and you know, obviously we live in Washington, so tons of water and inclement weather pretty much all the time. So that's the goal. Maybe I'll go ahead and lay these out and do a little b-roll for you guys so you can see the finished product, and then that's probably going to be it for the day. All right, guys, so I finished through those. I still didn't get the second row figured out. I messaged a couple friends also with flexes, because honestly I can't remember what the orientation is for that one curved corner. So I don't know which goes on which side and where the orientation is, because my car's not here. So I think I did decide that I really like the badge in the middle on the third row too. So that's what we're gonna go ahead and do now. Hopefully while we're doing that, I will hear back from somebody about the carpeted second row, and then we can go ahead and go from there. But I'm gonna grab this, put it over here, and get her all drilled and then get her going. Awesome third row badged up. And like I said, pretty much nobody sits in my third row, but all know it's there. It looks pretty awesome. Matches the rest of the all weather, so they'll just sit in there. I actually did hear my phone go off, so let me go ahead and check it and see if we heard from somebody about these other ones. Hopefully we did. Nope. We did. So, I guess we'll have to wait on those. That stinks. I was really hoping to get all of these done so that I could just check them off my list. My ever-growing list of stuff I have to do for this build, which that's building a car, yo. So I'm really happy with how everything turned out though. They look so good. So good. Let's check, is that one maybe? No. Anyway, I wish it was. But let's go ahead and I'll try to do some quick B-roll of how good these look. Hopefully it can capture how good they actually look, because they really look like OEM. So cue the B-roll. All right, guys, there you have it. We knocked out the floor mats.
We got both sets. I'll do those at another time.
I won't waste your guys' time filming that though. You guys saw how I did it. But there you go. Custom set of floor mats. They look 100% OEM. I love how they came out. These will be my show mats. These will be my daily mats. Either way, they're branded RS, so whoever sees them will know that's how we roll. So, as always, guys, please hit the subscribe button, like, share with your people, spread positivity in the car community. See you next time on Factory Fiction, where we are modified culture. Peace!